On our fair planet, all men are created equal. Women, not so much. You see, there's a certain section of the population that's somewhat less equal than others. That section earns less and pays more, and the only reason why is because they have vaginas.
It's true. We ladies are using our 4/5 of a wage to pay twice, thrice, sometimes 4 times the amount that men do for the exact same products and services. Yay!
If that sounds as preposterous as it should, head to your nearest supermarket and do some detective work.
Or you could just act normally, really, same thing.
But have a look at the prices. Same brands, same products, different costs.
We see it in personal care products. There's often quite a marked price difference. You might see $2 for the male one and $3 or $4 for the female one.
Deodorants, razors, the most obvious offenders.
Why? Oh, good question.
It's all in the marketing. You see it from day one, literally, the day you're born. It's blue for boys and pink for girls. And those colours that we wear eventually wear us down.
But I think because of the way we've kind of been programmed from birth, and we see it with toys, you're often just inclined to choose the product that's been designed to speak to you without really looking at the price.
But there are certain products with extra charges that aren't as obvious to detect, mainly because there's no male equivalent. That's right, period stuff.
Fortunately, someone has cottoned onto this and is actually doing something about it.
Speaking of cotton.
So this is my glorious giant tampon. I guess it's like the second stage in my campaign.
The first stage was this, a petition called Stop Taxing My Period.
All goods and services are taxed 10% under the GST, and then there are specific banners under which goods can be exempt. So under the health banner, you have goods like condoms and incontinence pads, nicotine replacement therapy, and the argument that we're making is that sanitary products should be under that health banner because they are necessary to the health of half the population.
You see, every month, we ladies are reminded of how generally shit our lives are by bleeding from our vaginas. That's why we buy these every month for 40 years.
These go into
no.
That.
We don't need to go into that.
I think the message is that periods are a biological function. It's not something that people get to choose, and so they shouldn't be taxed for them.
Well, that makes sense.
Yeah.
I'm not just saying that because I have a vagina. I think that genuinely makes sense.
Joe Hockey, who presumably doesn't have a vagina, apparently agrees.
Do you think that sanitary products are an essential health good for half the population?
Yes, the answer's yes.
Well, that was easy. Except regardless of what happens now, our collective hemorrhaging has already netted the government an estimated $375 million.
Hopefully this will stem a very heavy flow of sexism.
Well, that's good, but unfortunately it doesn't quite end there. Don't even get me started on services.
Take dry cleaning. A 2011 study found the average price of cleaning a men's shirt was $2.06, while a woman's shirt was $3.95. Now that doesn't include additional costs if, say, the item's made of a special fabric or has added extras. In other words, the price gap is for identical shirts, except one's labelled men's, the other women's. There's also evidence to show that women pay more for insurance and vehicle-based services at car dealerships and mechanics. The commonly held presumption is that women don't know or care enough about cars, which makes them an easier target to rip off.
Yeah, your thermospagmogneter has gone and shat itself.
Oh my God, the thermosmogman?
Yeah, it's going to cost you an extra $300.
Oh, I can't afford that right now.
Thought you worked on the telly.
SBS.
Oh, you're super f***.
Another key offender is the humble hairdresser. The same 2011 study found, on average, women paid around $35 for a basic haircut, while men paid around $23. We're talking a $12 difference for the same cut. Nothing fancy, nothing styled.
You guys should be ashamed of yourself. Overcharging women? Get the hell away from Janice Peterson.
Janice, are you okay? Whoa, whoa, whoa. You seem a bit upset.
I'm angry, Jill. I think I know what you need. Come with me.
That's why we need the Cheryl Kerno of services. Someone to keep the bastards honest.
Hello.
Hi.
And we found her.
Hey, welcome, welcome.
Thank you. So this is the workshop over
here. This is our workshop.
Kylie and her husband run a mechanic workshop in Adelaide. Some years ago, they began noticing common issues with some of their customers.
We get their cars in here, we have a look at work that's been done at another place, and suddenly we'll realise, hang on, this hasn't been changed at all.
What started out as a way of making the family business more accessible to women soon turned into a national directory listing businesses that serve women well.
You could put in your postcode what you were after, say if it's a mechanic or hairdresser, real estate, something like that, and who was a female-friendly recommended business, and you could read what other women have said.
Female Friendly relies on recommendations from other women, but there are similar sites that require businesses to meet certain criteria. And for a lot of businesses, especially those traditionally male-dominated, it's worth their while to do that.
From our point of view, what it does is it provides a platform for women to come in and feel trusted, feel comfortable and feel happy.
Do you know what would be really female friendly?
Tell me.
If you, like, gave women cars. Like Oprah.
You get a car! You get a car! Everybody gets a car!
But let's face it, nobody's like Oprah. That's not to say that you shouldn't try to be.
These are very female friendly.
There are people willing to bat an eyelid when it comes to sexist price gouging, and some are in very high places, like the French finance ministry. Which might sound random, sure, but this sort of thing happens everywhere, and France is essentially looking to stamp it out.
It's important to remember that what might end with the law ultimately starts with you. Places charge more because they can. Just don't buy it. Not the product or the bullshit.